Something a little bit different. We're not going to be necessarily going over a gun, but we're going to be going over why I have the gun set up the way I do right now. But before we do that, make sure you follow me on Instagram at madmaxguns, M-A-D-D-M-A-X-X guns. If you already follow me there, you would have seen this coming from a little while away. But if you don't, make sure you do that. You get like a sneak peek of what's coming up and stuff that I'll be coming down the pipe with, and like little outtakes and bloopers from time to time. But make sure you follow me there, and if you don't subscribe right, make sure you do that, and let's get into it. So what I have here is my OG AR, but I got rid of the muzzle brake, put on the A2 birdcage, got rid of the red dot that I was on here, put on the, I believe this would be considered like an A4 carry handle, it's just a M16 carry handle sight. Got rid of the CMC trigger that was on here and have a regular mil-spec trigger that tons of creep. Need to do that first. Tons of creep. And then the reset is very meh. It's about a 5-pound trigger, typical mil-spec stuff. Got rid of the Geissele Super 42 buffer system. And it has just a regular H2 buffer in there, and got rid of the bad lever. I mean, I shouldn't, I'm not a huge bad lever guy to begin with, but got rid of that. So this is like a real primitive gun. And the reason I did that, and I think it should be done more often by more people, especially if you're new to shooting, it's very easy to make bad habits because you have nicer gear, better trigger, a muzzle brake, a buffer system. I mean, a properly tuned gun is a properly tuned gun. All guns should really do that. But like having a gun that meshes so well where there's like no recoil at all, it will allow you to form bad habits without knowing you're forming bad habits. Like with this gun, if you're going to pop off a shot at 100 yards with the irons, right? With a regular Geissele trigger, you can just tap it, right? And then you're not gonna have any movement. But with a mil-spec trigger, it takes a little bit more force. And if you booger hook it too much or have too much finger on there or not enough finger, too much finger, you're gonna pull the shot a little left and you might not hit your target at 100 yards. Or if you don't have enough trigger, you're gonna push your shot right. I mean, I guess that depends what hand you shoot, but as a righty, that's what would happen. So with the single stage trigger or like a nice glass break Geissele trigger, that won't happen. With a mil-spec trigger, that will 100% happen. So that's a big thing, is forming habits, right? You want to form good habits. So if you do that with like mil-spec stuff, you're going to form yourself good habits, and then it will translate later on to when you have a nicer trigger and a muzzle brake and everything, and you'll be able to shoot like super fast, right? Another thing, shot speed. Usually with a mil-spec trigger, I'm shooting anywhere between like a 1-1 on a good day splits to like 1-5 splits. And like 1-3 on average, right? And that's like 5 round at 15 yards on paper or steel, whatever. It neither here nor there. But with this, 1-5, me again, 1-5 splits with this was like, I was pretty happy about it, right? So that also has to do with the muzzle brake. It's being able to tame it, and with out a muzzle brake and having an A2 birdcage hider, having an A2 flash hider on here, like a birdcage, it forces you to, you know, really pull it into you to mitigate that muzzle rise and to keep it like a real consistent thing, so you're not like banging around. Like, you'll see people, if they shoot in slow motion and without having like a gun that's super low recoil, it'll be like bouncing around when they're shooting. Get used to it and do the proper fundamentals, back to that again, and you're really pulling it into you, you're not gonna have a lot of muzzle rise, as you saw hopefully in the intro. So that's another thing, tame and muzzle rise, tame and trigger pull. And for me, the biggest thing is sight identification, right? So red dot, I happen to be left eye dominant. I learned shooting at a young age, taught by me by my family, who are all righties. I happen to be like a weird half lefty in certain things, but I'm left eye dominant, right? So when I go to shoot with a red dot, I can keep both eyes open and still find the target. This, my field of view is coming from my left eye, right? So I'm not picking up the sight. So I got to squint, which, in all actuality, I probably should be, like, I should definitely be a lefty shooter, because I can, like, pick up the sights mad easy, like this, right? It, boom, they're there. When I shoot righty, right, like I normally do, I have to bring it up, squint my left eye a little, and then get the good sight picture. Now, that, me being a left eye dominant, has a big effect on shooting with irons. Now, that's why I started shooting irons again, so reaction time. It also translates to pistol. I know you could tilt your head left and use your left eye, but you know, that's for a different time. Those are the three main things for me why I set this rifle up like this, and I've been shooting a lot lately. This right here is just like camo wrap that like people put on sniper rifles and stuff, but I'm using it as like a heat shield, because in the last video I did with this gun, I spoke about how much it burned my hand. And this got rid of that. I could shoot all day with this, but small side note on that. Those are the three main reasons why I have this set up the way I do, is to get my fundamentals back, to make sure I can have a good trigger squeeze, right? To tame the muzzle rise, to keep a nice flat shooting regardless of gun, and then reaction time with picking up the sights. Does that mean that you should shoot with irons and without a muzzle brake and a mil-spec trigger? Should you? Probably, yeah. It's good to learn like the basics, especially on a gun that is set up for basics. But do you have to? No. Just be wary to not form bad habits and let them grow, and then, yeah, just don't make bad habits. I don't know. This one's a short one. I just wanted to talk about why I had this rifle set up the way I do, why I believe that more people should do this more often. It's good to learn, like, go back to the basics from time to time. And I truly enjoyed it. While shooting always, like, presents challenges, like, this shooting in this setup gave me way more of a challenge. And trying to catch the speeds of what I was doing with, like, a red dot is, I don't know, I enjoy it. It gives me something to strive for, a light at the end of the tunnel, if you will. But I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you got something out of it. If you didn't, I mean, that's on you. But if you liked the video, make sure you hit like. If you didn't like the video, as always, eat a dick. If you don't subscribe already, make sure you do that, and I'll have some other videos coming down the pipe for you, and some other ones that you might like that are going to be over here somewhere around here. Again, follow me on Instagram if you don't already, and if you got any requests for anything, let me know. I'll see you guys next time. Peace out. Be good.